Can you get the coronavirus through food? We don't know of any known transmission of this new coronavirus through food. So your risk is considered super low of getting coronavirus through food right now. And that's according to the FDA and the CDC and all the experts we've chatted with. There are some things you can do, some general food safety practices that are gonna help keep you safe in your kitchen. And this has always been true. Wash your hands before you start cooking. And then again, before you start eating, frequent hand washing for 20 seconds with soap and warm water can be really helpful. Clean and disinfect commonly touched and used surfaces in your kitchen. That's really important right now. Just practice general safe guidelines. Another thing that's important to remember is not to share food with your family members. Try not to double dip. Try not to share silverware. Things that are just general food safety guidelines still are in place right now. Will heat from cooking kill the coronavirus? Yes, we think so. As with most viruses that are similar to this new coronavirus, heat will kill them, and that includes the temperature at which you're sauteing foods, microwaving foods till they're hot, or even slow cooking foods according to recipes instructions. That temperature should kill this new coronavirus. Do I need to wipe down my groceries when I come home from the store? So I've seen a lot of videos and on social media, people disinfecting their food when they bring it home from the grocery store. Right now, according to the experts we've talked to, and again, guidance from the FDA, you don't need to do that with your food. And in fact, if you're cleaning your food with chemicals and even soap, ingesting those chemicals in soap can be more dangerous for you. So again, your risk of getting this coronavirus through food is really low, but it's understandable that you want to stay safe. So there are some things you can do with your groceries when you come home from the store that will help without feeling like you need to sanitize everything. After you put your food away, make sure you're washing your hands really well and sanitizing any surfaces that those foods have been on. So wiping down a kitchen counter that you may be preparing food on later. That's important. Another thing you can do is just wash your produce. Again, you don't need soap to do this. You don't need any sort of chemical. Just wash your produce really well and use friction, especially on those fruits and vegetables that can tolerate it. The other thing you're just gonna wanna remember is to wash your hands before you start cooking with that food, and then again, before you start eating. How long does the virus live on surfaces that your food may be in, like plastic or cardboard? So the new research on coronavirus, research that I've seen, has shown that it can live up to one day on cardboard and 2 to 3 days on plastic and stainless steel. Again, right now, according to the CDC, the most believed way that people are contracting this new coronavirus is through coming into close contact with people who are sick. So not through touching surfaces that may have been contaminated. However, it's always a good idea, and especially right now, to continue to wash your hands really well for 20 seconds with soap and warm water, or use a hand sanitizer when you're unable to do that. Try not to touch your face, even when you're home. I think that's important to remember. Just try not to touch your face. And also to, again, continue to clean and disinfect those surfaces that are most frequently touched. So whether it's your kitchen countertop or the fridge handle, doorknobs, your cell phone, remember to do that to help keep yourself safe. What are some tips to stay safe while you're grocery shopping? That's a great question, because going to the grocery store might be one of the only places that you're going these days if you're not an essential worker. And you want to do everything you can to keep yourself and to keep others safe. So the first thing is, please don't go if you're feeling sick at all. Stay home. Look into other ways to get your groceries to your house, whether that's having them delivered or asking a friend to pick them up from you. I've heard very different stories from people across the country and even people right here about different grocery stores and what they're doing to help keep you safe. Some are wiping down carts for you and some are not. So what you can do is wipe down carts with the disinfecting wipes. They usually have them at the front door. Try not to touch your face when you're at the grocery store. Stay away from people at least 6 feet away. So if an aisle is really crowded, maybe skip that aisle for now. I would recommend also only bringing in what you need. So don't bring a purse, your wallet, a bunch of reusable grocery bags. Bring your credit or debit card, a method to pay for your groceries. It's recommended to use cards right now instead of cash. Bring in your grocery list, preferably written on paper and not your phone that you would need to be constantly touching. And again, maybe this is the time to skip the reusable bags. Some grocery stores have already stopped accepting them and just use the plastic or paper for now. Sanitize your hands when you get back to your car if you can, and again, after you put your groceries away. Is it safe to order takeout? Yes, there's no known transmission of this coronavirus through takeout. Whether you're picking it up or getting it delivered, try to do a no contact drop off where you either pay online or over the phone and the food is left somewhere where you can grab it, whether that's your front door or on a table, because you want to minimize your contact with people. Once you bring the takeout in and unload it, you would again want to wash your hands before you're eating, maybe reheat it if it needs to be heated. You don't need to go crazy sanitizing everything, every container. But again, if that makes you feel a little bit better to put the food into a container that you have at home, I say go for it. You have to do what helps make you feel better, but takeout should be safe right now. So we've written up a lot of these articles to answer your questions on eatingwell.com. So please head there to look for more detailed answers to these questions. Also remember, at the time of filming, these answers were accurate, but from what we know about this disease, things are changing all the time. So please consult with the latest guidelines and updates from the CDC, from the FDA, from your local public health department to help keep yourself and others safe. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to eatingwell.com on YouTube as we bring you more helpful tips and information, including recipes right now.